a mother. Okay? She had two daughters. Okay? One daughter was married to a man who makes umbrellas. You know umbrella? You go in the rain? And another daughter was married to a man who made noodles. Not only he made noodles, they both together had a business of making noodles. So they make noodle, dry it, pack it, and go sell it in the market. And this man and his wife, that's this lady's daughter, they used to make umbrellas. So they sell in the market. When it is raining, people buy the umbrellas. And that's how they make a living. So this lady at home, when it is sunny day, no rain, she is worried that her daughter must be suffering because there is no rain, you cannot sell umbrellas, right? Oh, so she's so sad. And when it is raining, she says, oh, my daughter cannot dry her noodles outside because it is raining and she cannot package and sell, so they must be suffering.
You mean the husband?
Yeah.
Son-in-law.
Yeah, son-in-law and daughter. So when it is raining, she is worried about the umbrella. And when it is sunny, she is worried about the noodle.
Opposite way.
Which means all the time she is worried. Instead of thinking the opposite, that when it is sunny, instead of worrying about the umbrella, she should be happy that this daughter and son-in-law can make a lot of noodles and dry it under the sun and they will make a good living. And when it is raining, instead of thinking about the noodle, she can think of the umbrella.
What about snow?
Yeah, snow umbrella also. This is just an example, a story, an old story. So it depends on how you look at things. When the right situation, in this situation, you don't start imagining something opposite and feel bad about it. When it is very sunny, don't say, oh, I wish it was a little cooler. When it is cold, if you wish, oh, it's too cold, I wish it was warmer, you know? So you are not happy when it is cold, you are not happy when it is hot, you are not happy when it is raining, you are not happy when it is snowing.
Snower.
Right? Snower. So this is a lesson of how to be happy under all conditions. Right?
If one of them has a business, the business is slow, but the other guy's business is slow.
Exactly. It is like the example you might have heard, a glass is half water, half empty. So a lot of people look at the glass, I wish it was full, it is half empty. Oh. Another person will say, oh, it's so nice, it's half full.
Right?
So it depends on the glass, it is half full. Which is nice.
It's the same.
No.
When you say, oh, no, it is half empty. Ah, that's not very good. Right?
It's the same.
No.
So, from these stories, short stories, there are a lot of things you learn. And that is why Einstein, one of the greatest scientists ever, he was very much interested in children's education. And he said a lot of things about how to educate children. And he said, when you want bright, intelligent children, when you want them to grow to be intelligent, tell them stories. fairy tales, imaginative examples. And when you want them to be more intelligent, tell them more stories and more imagination, more fairy tales. Right? So, such a wonderful quotation from Einstein. Okay?